Okay, play this game with us. Cast your mind back to 1998 when the most played song on Aussie radio was this. Smash it, Kyles.
Bachelor Girls took the country by storm with their debut album, going platinum twice. Fast forward 25 years and the duo still going strong, having just released their brand new single, Calling Out Your Name. Okay, James Roche joining us live. Hi, team.
Hey, guys.
Hi, hi.
We'll get into the new song in just a moment, which is fabulous. But let's go back a couple of decades. Yeah. Buses and trains. Every time it comes on, everyone freaks out in song. How did your lives change with that song?
Oh, it went from, you know, absolute, you know, being anonymous to going to clubs with friends and people saying, is that you? And I said, no, it's not me, because the goodbye would be too long, you know, like the whole thing would be, like, I need to leave now, and it would just be, so, yeah, zero to 150.
Wow. With the benefit of hindsight and a quarter of a century behind us now, is there anything you would have done differently during that time, you reckon?
I would have paid more attention. You know,
what do you mean?
We were so busy and we were always concentrating on what's next, what's the next song, what's the next production, what's the next tour, that I was hardly paying attention to what was going on in the moment.
So didn't you enjoy the moment?
No, that's right. I had all that and I feel like I watched it on TV once. Mm. So I'm really careful about paying attention to right now, being in the moment, experiencing life. Otherwise, I'll just get to, you know, 99 drop dead and I will have missed the whole thing.
Yeah. Well, you still have all these clips.
So you parted ways in 2003, got back together 2011, released a single called Speak in 2018. Mm. So was it easy to get back into the groove? I know you were still writing music all the way along, but was it easy to get back in the groove?
I think the break, and we never, you know, it was always amicable. We're always good friends.
Yeah.
But, you know, and obviously not being together helps that, you know, like we didn't follow in the footsteps of the Eurythmics and Fleetwood Mac and all that kind of thing. But I think having that break means it's like you sort of feel rejuvenated when you get back together.
Yes.
And thankfully the songs, the messages haven't gone old. They haven't turned into like, oh, that's not relevant anymore. Mm. So with every audience we play them to, it's just, you know, the reckless abandon, I keep saying that, but they're just so into the lyric and it's all that nostalgia. And then, you know, being able to still write songs together gives us an extra kind of extra fuel to keep going.
Except there's now light rail instead of the train.
That's right.
Things have come a little.
I threw you under the Tesla. Yeah. Now, you're currently touring with another star of the night. He's Darren Hayes from Savage Garden. I saw this the other night. I saw you guys in full flight. And I tell you what, you are jumping around like an Olympic gymnast and the audience is loving this music still. Every word, every dance step.
Yeah.
Well done.
Thanks, Larry. And I was actually impressed that you were even there, given that you do morning television.
Yeah, 8 o'clock at night is very late for me.
That is very late.
I did have to have a nana nap in the afternoon.
Yeah, you did, a disco nap.
But listen, this must be great fun, back up on the tools, in front of an audience that's your happy place.
Look, it's why we do it. Yeah, it's why we do it. It's you know, being on the couch and, you know, being quiet for a couple of years during COVID was not fun.
Is it surprising to you that after all these years, that audience could have been out of the 90s, right? They were just going berserk.
Yeah,
is that surprising that the
music's the lyrics, which is really satisfying. We, you know, break down the song and the whole stadium is singing the lyrics.
Yeah.
It's the best moment.
Okay. It is.
Let's talk about the new single, Calling Out Your Name. What's the song about? What's the vibe?
James. Well,
you know that feeling that somehow you're living plan B of your life and out there somewhere is... There's a plan A out there that you're not having.
Kylie, unfortunately, never got to marry a prince in Buckingham Palace.
But she gets to hang with you.
All right. Yeah, thank you.
This song is about how plan A keeps gently calling, tapping us on the shoulder, saying, come and find me.
Yeah. He's out there somewhere, Kyle. He's out there somewhere.
My prince.
New music, making you happy, feeling good.
Yeah, it's fabulous. I mean, we've still got things to say. I've been in Sweden for 10 years, so I've got a lot of things to say about that. Moved interstate. Love moving around. I think that's the fuel for creativity, you know, keeping it interesting. And thankfully we're still good mates, and and we've got this great band. We're really enjoying it, and we're loving touring with Darren Hayes right now.
Yeah.
And you know, we've got another show. Brisbane,
yep.
And show tomorrow night, our own show in Burley Heads, if I can give that a plug.
Sure.
Yeah.
Well, great to see you guys. It was so good to see you on stage the other night. It took us all right back to the 90s.
Thanks, lady.
We are a time machine.
Yeah, I was the one singing out of tune, right? Yeah. Thanks.
Calling Out Your Name is Bachelor Girls' new single, and it is available right now. It's out.
Soon for you, the most...